Hi everyone, how are you today? Welcome back. And if you are new here, welcome to my channel, where you can learn the real world coding experience. And this is Hong, the coding expert. If you want to pass any coding exam to start your coding career, or if you are already holding a coding credential, working in the field, and want to learn more in order to advance your coding profession, then you are in the right place. Time really flies by so quickly. I just talked about the summer in one of my videos. Now it is already gone. The fall is here, and before you know it, Thanksgiving and Christmas are coming. You will be busy during the holidays, so don't forget to set aside some time each day for study. If you could pass the coding exam this year, then I believe it could be one of the best Christmas presents for yourself in terms of personal achievement. I wish you all the best on your journey to become a successful coder. Today's topic is CBC, COC, CCS, and CCS-P exam prep in 2021, the medicine section. You will have a chance to cover services and procedures that you need to know for the coding exam and also for work. Alright, without further ado, let's get started. Question number one. What is the correct CPT code to use for this service? Individual psychotherapy, 45 minutes with patient. Psychotherapy is a general term for treating mental health problems by talking with a psychiatrist, psychologist, or other mental health providers. During psychotherapy, you learn about your condition and your moods, feelings, thoughts, and behaviors. I will put on a short 30-second music while waiting for you to open your CPT book and find the right code for this service. Please pause the video and do it now. Alright, let's see how you did. In the index in your CPT book, if you look under the main term psychotherapy, individual patient, it will give you a code range 90832 to 90838. Your next step is to review these available codes in the tabular list, and here's what you find. 90834. Psychotherapy, 45 minutes with patient. And this is the right code to use for 45 minutes psychotherapy session. That said, the correct answer to this question is 90834. Question number two. What is the correct CPT code to use for this service? The black scan of right lower extremity arteries. Ultrasound is a procedure that uses sound waves to see inside your body. An arterial duplex ultrasound uses sound waves to create a color map of the arteries in your legs to identify narrowing of your vessel that may be causing leg pain when walking, resting leg pain, foot, ankle, heel or toe ulcers, skin discoloration. I will book on a short 30-second music while waiting for you to open your CPT book and find the right code for this procedure. Please pause the video and do it now. Alright, let's see how you did. In the index in your CPT book, if you look under the main term, the black scan, arterial studies, lower extremity, it will give you a call range 93925 to 93926. Your next step is to check these available codes in the tabular list, and here's what you find. 93925, the breast scan of lower extremity arteries or arterial bypass graft, complete bilateral study. 93926, this is an identical, so it includes all the information from the code verbal 93925, which is the pairing code, except 93926 is for a unilateral study. And this is the right code to use for this procedure. That said, the correct answer to this question is 93926. Question number 3. What is the correct CPT code to use for this procedure? EEG coma. Doctors use an electroencephalogram EEG detects brain activity in 50% of clinically unresponsive patients. They use the EEG to gather data from adult patients in an intensive care unit who had recently experienced injuries, unable to talk or respond to commands. I will book on a short 30-second music while waiting for you to open your CBT book and find the right code for this procedure. Please pause the video and do it now. Alright, let's see how you did. In the index in your CBT book, if you look under the main term, electroencephalography, EEG, recording, coma only, it will give you just one code, 95822. And because 95822 is an identical, so I will show you its pairing code. 95816. Electroencephalogram, EEG, including recording, awake, and drowsy. 95822. This is an identical, so it includes all information from the code verbal 95816, which is the pairing code, except 95822 is recording in coma or sleep only. And this is the right code to use for this procedure. That said, the correct answer to this question is 95822. Question number 4. What is the correct CPT code to use for this service? Chiropractic manipulation of the spine, cervical, thoracic, and lumbar regions. The goal of spinal manipulation is to reduce pain and restore function to mechanical disorders of the spinal column. I will book on a short 30-second music while waiting for you to open your CPT book and find the right code for this procedure. Please pause the video and do it now. Alright, let's see how you did. In the index in your CBT book, if you look under the main term, chiropractic manipulation, spinal, it will give you a code range 98940 to 98942. Your next step is to review these available codes in the tabular list, and here's what you get. 98940, chiropractic manipulative treatment, CMT, spinal, 1 to 2 regions. 98941, this is unidentical, so it includes all the information from the cover bow. 98940, which is the pericope, except 98941 is for spinal, 3 to 4 regions. And this is the right code to use for 3 areas of the spine, cervical, thoracic, and lumbar region were manipulated. That said, the correct answer to this question is 98941. Question number 5. What is the correct CPT code to use for this procedure? Fluorescent angiogram. A fluorescent angiography is a medical procedure in which a fluorescent dye is injected into the bloodstream. The dye highlights the blood vessel in the back of the eye so they can be photographed. This test is often used to manage eye disorder. Your doctor may order to confirm a diagnosis, determine an appropriate treatment, or monitor the condition of the vessels in the back of your eye. I will put on a short 30-second music while waiting for you to open your CPT book and find the right code for this procedure. Please pause the video and do it now. Alright, let's see how you did. In the index in your CBT book, if you look under the main term angiography, fluorescent, it will give you two codes, 92235 and 92242. Your next step is to double check these two available codes in the tabular list, and here's what you find. 92235. Fluorescent angiography includes multi-frame imaging with interpretation and report, unilateral or bilateral. And this is the right code to use for this angiogram procedure. On another note, when you see the code description includes the term bilateral, in other words, both eyes, then modifier 50 is not applicable. That said, the correct answer to this question is 92235. Now, if you are coding in the real world, nobody gives you multiple codes to choose from, like the CBC exam. You have to read the procedure report, understand what they are doing, then use your CBT book or coding software to find the right code for each record. And believe it or not, your code will determine the hospital reimbursement, in other words, how much money the hospital will receive for those services. Now you understand why I want you to practice coding questions like this when you have to look up procedures code using the main terms. Let's continue to the next question. Question number 6. What is the correct CPT code to use for this IM intramuscular injection? Rabies, immune globulin, performed under direct physician supervision. Rabies immune globulin is used together with rabies vaccine to prevent infection caused by the rabies virus. It works by giving your body the antibodies it needs to protect it against the rabies virus. This is called passive protection. This passive protection lasts long enough to protect your body until it can produce its own antibodies against the rabies virus. I will book on a short 30-second music while waiting for you to open your CBT book and find the right code for this injection. Please pause the video and do it now. Alright, let's see how you did. In the index in your CBT book, if you look under the main term rabies immunoglobulin, RIG, human, it will give you just one code, 90375. Your next step is to double check this code in the tabular list and hear what you get. 90375, rabies immunoglobulin, ILG, human, for intramuscular and or subcutaneous use. And this is the right code to use for the rabies immunoglobulin. However, if you read the instructional note preceding the code 90281, it will tell you that 90281 to 90399 only identify the serum globulin extracted from the human blood. In other words, the substance is being injected. You still have to report the method of administration in addition to the product codes. And in this case, this is an intramuscular injection, IM. It also gives you quite a few codes to choose from. And after reviewing this code, I find that 96372, therapeutic, prophylactic, or diagnostic injection, specifies substance or drug, subcutaneous or intramuscular. And this is the right code to use in addition to 90375. Now you see both the protocol or the substance is being injected in 90375 is reported in addition to the procedure code 96372. That said, the correct answer to this question is 90375 and 96372. I hope that you write a note next to this code 90375 in your CBT book. Just a friendly reminder that if you enjoy what you have learned so far and appreciate my time spent for this video, then you could please pause the video, click the like, subscribe, and share buttons below now to support my channel, and that would be great. You are the reason why I continue making these learning videos, because I really want you to pass the coding exam and also have more confidence at work. You're passing the exam, and your comments really inspire and keep me going. Thank you so much for your support, and we should move on to the next question. Question number 7. What is the correct CPT code to use for this procedure? Chemotherapy administered into the peritoneal cavity via inwelling port. During intraperitoneal chemotherapy, the medication will directly target the cancer in the peritoneal space. I will book on a short 30-second music while waiting for you to open your CPT book and find the right code for this procedure. Please pause the video and do it now. Alright, let's see how you did. In the index in your CBT book, if you look under the main term chemotherapy, peritoneal cavity, it will give you just one code, 96446. Your next step is to double check this code in the tabular list and hear what you find. 96446, chemotherapy, administration into the peritoneal cavity via inwelling port or catheter. And this is the right code to use for this procedure. That said, the correct answer to this question is 96446. Question number 8. What is the correct CPT code to use for this procedure? Bronchospasm, provocation evaluation. The bronchial provocation test evaluates how sensitive the airways in your lungs are. A spirometric breathing test is done before and after you inhale mist. One example of the mist that may be inhaled is methacholine. Spirometry can show how much air you can breathe in and out. It can help your doctor evaluate symptoms suggestive of asthma, such as cough, chest tightness, and shortness of breath, and help diagnose whether or not you have asthma. I will book on a short 30-second music while waiting for you to open your CPT book and find the right code for this procedure. Please pause the video and do it now. Alright, let's see how you did. In the index in your CPT book, if you look under the main term, provocation test, bronchospasm evaluation, it will give you just one code, 94070. Your next step is to duplicate this code in the top of the list and hear what you get. 94070, bronchospasm. Provocation evaluation, multiple spirometric determination, as in 94010, with administered agent, e.g., antigen, cold air, methacholine. And this is the right code to use for this procedure. In addition, I want you to highlight a note under this code 94070. Report antigen administration separately with 99070 or appropriate supply code. However, the antigen is not given in this case. That said, the correct answer to this question is 94070. Question number 9. If you have been watching my videos, then you should know my backwards approach very well by now. You analyze the answer first and then read the procedure report after. This case is very straightforward. A, B, C, and D all have different codes. 96401, 96402, 96413, and 96405. So they are in four separate groups. All you have to do now is open your CPT book and then look them up. Please pause the video and do it now. Assuming you already looked them up in your CPT book and hear what you get. 96401, chemotherapy, administration, subcutaneous or intramuscular, non-hormonal, anti-neoplastic. 96402, this is unidentical, so it includes all the information from the code above. 96401, which is the pairing code, except 96402 is for hormonal, anti-neoplastic, whereas 96401 is for non-hormonal, anti-neoplastic. 96405, chemotherapy, administration, intralesional, up to and including 7 lesions. 96413, chemotherapy, administration, intravenous infusion technique, up to 1 hour, single or initial substance drug. Follow my tips and strategy. You highlight the main difference between each CPT code. And after you're done highlighting, you should know what your focus is when you read the question or a procedure report. Let's read it. A prostate cancer patient is seen in the office for leuprolide, hormones releasing ingonis therapy administered subcutaneously. Based on what I just highlighted, you can tell this patient is given leuprolide hormone releasing agonist therapy subcutaneously. So 96402 is the right code to use because it is a hormonal anti-neoplastic given subcutaneously. That said, the correct answer to this question is 96402. Question number 10. Before we tackle this case, it is very similar to what you will see on the CBC, COC, or other coding exams. You get nervous when you see a surgery or procedure that you are not familiar with. For instance, in this case, cardiac catheterization procedure. And as a result, you lose your focus during the exam. That is why you must follow my backward strategy, which is to analyze the answer first and then read the report after. And I am the only one who tackle coding exam this way. Follow my tips and strategy. A and D have the same code, 93451, so they are in the same group. B and C have different codes, 93454 and 93530, so they are in separate groups. Now you know, there are three groups, so there are three codes for you to look up in your CPT book, 93451, 93454, and 93530. Please pause the video and do it now. Assuming you already looked them up in your CBT book, and here's what you get. 93451, dry heart catheterization, including measurement of oxygen, saturation, and cardiac output when performed. 93454, catheterization placement in coronary arteries for coronary angiography, including intra-procedural injection for coronary angiogram. And 93530, right heart catheterization for congenital cardiac anomalies. Follow my tips and strategy. You highlight the main difference between each CPT code. And after you're done highlighting, you can tell the only difference between 93451 and 93530 is that they both are for the right heart catheterization, but 93530 is for congenital cardiac anomalies, and 93454 is for the coronary angiogram only, nothing to do with the right heart catheterization. Now, you should have an idea what your focus is when you read the question or the procedure report. Let's read it. A cardiac clinic performs several cardiac catheterization procedures. Which of the following would be correct to report a right heart catheterization with measurement of oxygen saturation? Based on what I just highlighted, a right heart catheterization with measurement of oxygen saturation is performed and not for congenital cardiac anomaly. So, 93451, right heart catheterization, is the right code to use for the procedure. Therefore, we can eliminate B and C from here. A and D still remain. And the only difference between these two answers is that D has 93456, which A doesn't have. So, please pause video, open your CPT book, and look up this code 93456 and find out what it is. Please pause video and do it now. assuming you already look it up in your CBD book and hear what you find. 9456 coronary angiography with right heart catheterization. Based on the question, a coronary angiogram is not performed, so it is not the right code to report in this case. Having said that, the correct answer to this question is 92451 for the right heart catheterization only. Question number 11. Again, follow my backward strategy, which is to analyze the answer first and then read the report after. This case is very straightforward. A, B, C, and D all have different codes. 92601, 92603, 92604, and 92950. So they are in four separate groups. All you have to do now is open your CBT book and look them up. Please pause video and do it now. Assuming you already looked them up in your CBT book and hear what you find. 92601, diagnosis, analysis of cochlear implant, patient younger than 7 years of age with programming. 92603, diagnostic, analysis of cochlear implant, age 7 years or older with programming. 92604, this is an identical, so it includes all the information from the cover ball, 92603, which is the parent code, except 92604 is for subsequent reprogramming. 92950, hearing aid examination and selection, Monaro. Follow my tips and strategy, you highlight the main difference between each CBD code, and after you're done highlighting, you could tell the only difference between 92601 and 92603 is related to the age of the patient. 92601 is for patient younger than 7 years old, and 92603 is for patient age 7 years or older. 92604 is for a subsequent reprogramming, in other words, performed after the initial reprogramming, and 92950 is for the hearing aid examination. Now, you should know what your focus is when you read the question or a procedure report. Let's read it. 9-year-old patient had a recent placement of a cochlear implant. Based on what I just highlighted, this is a 9-year-old patient who had the recent placement of a cochlear device implant. So, 92601 does not apply because this code is for patients younger than 7 years old. 92950 also doesn't apply because it is for the hearing aid. Therefore, we can eliminate A and D from here. B and C still remain. And the only difference between these two codes is that 92604 is for a subsequent reprogramming. So let's continue reading. He and his family sees an audiologist to check the pressure and determine the strength of the magnet. The transmitter, microphone, and cable are connected to the external speech processor, and maximum loudness levels are determined under programming computer control. Based on what I just highlighted, this is not a subsequent reprogramming, so 92603 is the right code to use for this visit. That said, the correct answer to this question is 92603. Now, you understand why, with my backward approach, you can tackle almost every single case, even you don't even know much about some particular surgery or procedure on the exam. I hope that you have learned something new and valuable, not just for the coding exam, but also for every working in the real world of coding. That is all for now. Thank you so much for watching, for liking, and sharing this video. If you find this video is helpful, informative, and easy to learn with this format, or if you have any suggestion, then please leave me a comment below just to let me know. I really appreciate it. Also, the more positive comments that you leave for me, the better chance for my videos will be reviewed by other people. So please continue to do so. Until next time, have a great day.